Today we will solve a few numerical problems on bevel gear or design of bevel gear. So as you earlier we have earlier discussed about the design procedure of bevel gear, so by following this design procedure we can solve many numerical problems on bevel gear. So start from the first numerical problem. And bevel gear, as we earlier discussed, that finds application in automobiles and many other places also. So it can transmit power at 90 degree or any other angles, maybe 60 degree, 70 degree or 80 degree according to the requirements. Okay, so the first numerical problems on bevel gear is in front of you. So I read statement for you and after that we will solve this problem one by one, okay, and step by step. So statement for question number one is that two shaft right angle to each other are connected by a pair of bevel gears having full depth involute teeth. The pinion having 20 teeth transmit 40 kilowatt at 750 rpm to a gear shaft running at 375 rpm. If the allowable static stress for pinion and the gear material is 170 megapascal respectively, determine module pitch diameter and face width from here we have written as the strength consideration, from the strength consideration, okay, not the face width consideration. So what we have to do, as in the statement is some conditions are given. One is that the power is transmitted between two bevel gears or bevel gear pair, okay, and the number of teeth on pinion is mentioned, that is 20 teeth. Power transmitted by the pinion is given, that is 40 kilowatt, and RPM for pinion and gear is mentioned or given. And similarly, the static stress is given for both pinion as well as gear. So we have to determine the dimensions of the gear, and how we can determine, I will solve this numerical for you, and how we can solve very easily by step by step. So students, this is the given data for this question. Teeth on the pinion is given. We can denote it as capital TP or ZP. In different books may be denoted by different word. So I will denote it teeth on pinion by capital TP and ZP. You may use any of the one, TP or ZP. Power is denoted by capital V, that is 40 kilowatt. So we can also convert this 40 kilowatt in watt, that means 40 into 10 to power 3. Similarly, speed of pinion is given, that is 750 rpm. Speed of gear is given, that is 375 rpm. And one more thing, that is static stress for pinion is given, 100 megapascal. Static stress for gear is mentioned, that is, or given, 75 megapascal. We have assumed some three terms before starting solving the question. So first we have to assume that 20 degree full depth involute, that the system of the gear have 20 degree full depth involute system. That means the making of the teeth on the gear is 20 degree full depth involute. We assume that. Second one is material selection for pinion and gear. We have to select material for the pinion and gear. Okay. If we have given the static stress for both, then we have no need to select the material. We can find the material from the data design book with the help of 100 megapascal and 70 megapascal. And the third assumption is that value of factor of safety, service factor and load distribution factor is also taken from the data design book. So these are the three assumptions, and we will take these values. We will assume these values, and then we will solve this question. So students, as from the given data, first of all we can find out the gear ratio or velocity ratio easily. You know that what is gear ratio and velocity ratio. Gear ratio and velocity ratio is same. No, there is no difference between gear ratio and velocity ratio. So the gear ratio is equal to teeth on the follower divided by teeth on the driver. And it is also equal to speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower. So the speed of the driver and speed of the follower is given. So 750 rpm divided by 375 rpm, we will get the velocity ratio. And we have TP is also given, that is teeth on the pinion. So we have the three values, that means the speed of the driver, speed of the follower, and we have the teeth on the pinion. From this equation, gear ratio, we can easily find out the teeth on the gear also. So from this equation, we will get teeth on gear is equal to 40, and the teeth on the pinion is given. Okay. So teeth on the pinion is given, that means that teeth on the pinion is 20. So here is not the, this one is ZP, that means TP or ZP, not ZG. Okay. So TP or ZP is given in the statement, that is 20. And this one is find out by gear ratio. Okay. So pitch cone angle. Okay. Next step, after finding the teeth, number of teeth on gear and pinion, then we find out the pitch cone angle. So pitch cone angle, we have to find out pitch cone angle for both pinion as well as gear. And what is the pitch cone angle? The angle, the pitch cone angle is the angle made by the pinion with the axis. Okay. Similarly, the angle made by the gear with the axis of the shaft is known as pitch cone angle of the gear. So what is the formula for the pitch cone angle for pinion? So pitch cone angle for pinion, that means tangent phi p. Here I denote pitch cone angle by phi p. Okay. So in other books, maybe it may be denoted by different notation. So it is, we can denote it in different book with different notation. So tangent phi p is equal to tp by tg, or we can say that zp by zg. So we have the value of tp, that is the 20, and we have the value of tg, that is 40. So 20 by 40 means 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5. So similarly, and how we can find out the value of phi p? We can find out the value of phi p by taking tangent in the opposite side, that means tangent inverse. Okay, tangent inverse of 0.5 will give you 26.56 for phi p. This is the pitch cone angle for pinion. Phi p represent pitch cone angle for pinion, and 5g represent pitch cone angle for gear. So similarly, we can easily find out the pitch cone angle for gear also. Okay. So students, after finding the pitch cone angle for gear and pinion, we will find out the virtual or formative or equivalent number of teeth. So TE, capital TE, is also known as virtual number of teeth. It is also known as formative number of teeth or equivalent number of teeth. So different book denote different. So it is same. Okay. So how we can find out this value, equivalent number of teeth? So we can find out equivalent number of teeth for pinion as well as gear. Okay. So TEP, TEP represent equivalent number of teeth for pinion, and it is equal to TP, yani teeth on pinion, divided by cos of pitch angle, pitch cone angle. Okay. Cos of pitch cone angle for pinion. So we will get the answer, because teeth on the pinion is given, that is 20. And cos of 5p, 5p we already calculate in our last step. So from here we will get the TEP, that is 22.36. And in the next step we will find out equivalent number of teeth for gear. And the formula for equivalent number of teeth on gear is TG divided by cos of 5G. Okay. And TG we have already calculate in our previous step, that is 40. And 5G we already calculate from the calculation, we will get 89.46. After finding the equivalent number of teeth, we can easily find out Lewis form factor from the Lewis equation. So students, we already assume that this statement from the starting, we already assume that the system is 20 degree full depth involute system, 20 degree full depth involute system. For 20 degree full depth, we can take the Lewis form factor formula, okay, from the data design book. So from data design book, we will get the Lewis form factor formula for pinion is equal to 0.484 minus 2.87 divided by TEP for pinion. Okay. And we will get the calculation is at 0.3556. Similarly, students, we will find out the Revis form factor for gear. That is 0.484 minus 2.87 divided by TEG. TEG is nothing but the equivalent number of teeth on gear. So from by putting the value of TEP and TEG, we will get the Revis form factor for gear and pinion only. By getting these values, we will go for the checking of which is the weaker section. Okay, so which is weaker section. So by multiplying YP with the sigma BP, that means the static stress for pinion, and YG with sigma BG, that means static stress for gear, we will get the values, that is 35.56 and 31.63. So between these two values, 31.63 is lower value or lesser value than the 35.56. So which one is the lesser value? That member of the gear is weaker. Okay. So check for weaker member as clear from the Revis form factor. Gear has the lesser value. So gear is weaker. So design consideration on the basis of gear. So we will design now for gear only, not for pinion, because pinion is stronger than the gear. Okay. And bending strength, or bending strength is denoted by FB or WT. Okay, so sigma BG, the formula for bending strength is sigma BG dot B dot M dot YG and bracket 1 minus B divided by A naught, where A naught is a pitch cone distance. A naught is the pitch cone distance. Okay, and what is the distance? How we can denote A naught? A naught is the distance from the center cone, or we can say that apex to the face of the tooth of the bevel gear. It is the distance between the apex of the bevel gear to the face, up to the face of the bevel gear. Okay, is known as the pitch cone distance. So here, students, A naught is, that is A naught is equal to dp by 2, and the bracket close, complete ka whole square. Similarly, dg by 2 and complete ka whole square, and whole and under the root. The whole value is under the root. So this is the formula. I again explain you the formula for pitch cone distance, that is dp by 2 the whole square plus dg by 2 ka whole square and under the root. Complete value is under the root. So we have already given the data, that is the values for dp and dg. If not given, we will find out these values with the help of the module, and we have already given the values of tg and tp. So module is equal to dp by tp, similarly dg by tp. So from here, dp and dg, we will get the values in the module form, and by putting these values, we will get A naught in module form, that is 22.36 module. M is denoted by a module. Okay, so face width is equal to A naught divided by 3, or 10 m. So from these two values, which one is lesser, we will take the value of face width. If A naught by 3 is lesser than 10 m, we will take the face width as A naught by 3. If 10 m is lesser than A naught by 3, then we will take 10 m. So here in this question, A naught by 3 is equal to 7.45 module. So this is the value we will take for the face width. By putting these values in above equation of bending strength, that is the value of FB, we will get the value of FB. So by putting these whole values in this equation, we will get FB is equal to 157.67 module Newton. Okay, this M is represent module. Okay, so effective load, after finding the bending strength, we will go for the effective load, and the formula for effective load is equal to Ka Km into Ft divided by Cb. Cb is a velocity factor here. Okay, so for finding the Ft, we will take the power divided by pitch line velocity. So power is given in the start of the question, given data, and V is the pitch line velocity, and we can find out the V easily by pi d g n g divided by 60. So you already know that the weaker section is gear. So we will take the values for DG and NG. Okay. So we will design for gear only. In the next step, values of sigma B, bending face width, module is not given, and YG and the B and A not, we will get FB is equal to 157.67 module. And after that, we will find the values for the effective load. Okay. So estimation of module on strength basis, you know that FB is equal to what? F effective into factor of safety. By comparing it, we will get the value of module. That is, by comparing FB with F effective into factor of safety, we will get the value of module, that is 10 mm. And by putting the value of module in face width, we will get face width, we will get DG, we will get DP, we will get addendum, we will get addendum. So these are complete are the dimensions for bevel gear. Okay. So students, this is our complete first question. What we have to find out, the all the values we have in the end find out. Okay. So this is our second question. A 35 kilowatt motor running at 1200 rpm drives a compressor at 780 rpm through a 90 degree bevel gear arrangement. The pinion has 30 teeth and the pressure angle of teeth is 14.5 degree. The wheels are capable of withstanding a dynamic stress and wear. Sigma W working stress, we can say that is equal to 140 bracket 280 divided by 280 plus V. So sigma W is a working stress and that is equal to 140. Here 140 is a static stress, that is sigma naught. So sigma naught bracket 280 divided by 280 plus V megapascal. MPa here is a megapascal. Where V is pitch line velocity. The forum factor for teeth may be taken as Y is equal to 0.124 minus 0.686 divided by TE. That is TE is a equivalent number of teeth, okay, of bevel gear. The face width may be taken as 1/4 of the slant height of pitch cone. Slant height of pitch cone, that means A naught, capital A naught. Determine module and face width. We have to find out module and face width. Okay. So dear students, this is the given data, that is power given, slant speed of pinion given, that is NP, speed of gear given, teeth on the pinion given, and the condition for face width is equal to 1/4 of A naught. Sigma naught is given, that is 140, that means static stress. Y Lewis form factor condition is given. Pressure angle is given 14.5. Gear ratio or velocity ratio, we can easily find out by the ratio of speeds, that means speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower. So you, from the statement, that is clear, the driver is pinion and the follower is gear. So speed of driver, that means 1200, and speed of follower 780. So we will get the velocity ratio, that means 1.538, and the value of TP, that means the teeth on pinion is given. So three values are given, we can easily find out the teeth on the gear, that is 46. Okay. So after finding the teeth on the gear, we can easily find out the pitch cone angle for pinion and gear. Okay. Pitch angle for pinion and gear. So 5P, we can easily find out 33 degree, as is earlier in questions we already find out the from the formula. So 5G is 57 degree, and the formative number of teeth, the formula of formative number of teeth for pinion, that is TP divided by cos 5P, that is gives 35.8, and TG divided by cos of 5G gives 84.4. And after finding the TEP, that means equivalent number of teeth for pinion, equivalent number of teeth for gear, we can easily find out Lewis forum factor. Okay. And the Lewis forum factor gives you the values for pinion and gear. So by taking these values, we will go for check for the weaker section. Which one is the weaker? That is pinion weaker or gear weaker. Okay. So students, we will multiply static stress with pinion, static stress with gear, Lewis form factor. Okay. Static stress with Lewis form factor for pinion, and static stress for Lewis form factor for gear. and these values gives 14.7 and 16.24. From these two values we will get the values for pinion is weaker or smaller than the values for gear. So we will design for pinion because pinion is weaker here. So pinion has lesser value, so pinion is weaker, so we will design for the pinion. And next, in the next step we will find out the beam strength formula, or we will write the beam strength formula. So the formula for beam strength is sigma BP. That means BP is used for static stress for pinion. B is face width, M is module, and YP is a Lewis form factor for pinion. So dear students, by putting the values or finding these all values and putting it, we will get the formulation, we will get the answer which we required. So we already know that 140 is the static stress, okay, and this value is for the CV, that means velocity factor, okay, and B is the face width, that means 1 by 4 of the pitch cone angle A naught. M is module, so we don't have the value of module. And YP is 14.7, that is already calculated. So I already told you that the formula for A naught, that is pitch cone angle, is equal to, so formula for pitch cone angle is dp by 2 ka whole square, and dg by 2 ka whole square, and this whole term is under the root. So this is the formula for A naught, that is dp by 2 whole square plus dg by 2 whole square under the root. This whole term is under the root. So this is the formula for finding the value of A naught. So after finding A naught, we will also find dp, that means pitch circle diameter for pinion and pitch circle diameter for gear. So module is equal to dp by tp, and module is equal to dg by tg. So tg and tp, you know, already know that teeth on pinion and teeth on gear. So we will find the value of dp and dg in the form of module, okay, and put these values in the above statement or above beam strength question or beam strength equation. So after finding dg and dp, we will find ft. Ft, you know that tangential tooth load, or we can say that beam strength is equal to power divided by pitch line velocity, where V is equal to pi dp np divided by 60. You already know that pinion is weaker, so we will design for pinion. We will take dp np, okay. So after finding these values, we will find effective F effective, okay, effective load, that means, and effective load is equal to ka km multiplied by ft divided by cv. Cv is velocity factor, and ka and km already discussed that this is a service factor and km is a load stress factor. And these values is taken from the data design book. If not given, we will take one in place of ka and km, okay. So estimation module gives you f, we can estimate or we can compare the value of fb with f effective, okay. We can compare these values, and by comparing we will find out the value of module, okay. So students, we will require dp and dg in the A naught formula, and by putting the values in A naught, we will get the fb, and by comparing fb with f effective into factor of safety, we will get the module, the value for module. So this is our third question. Design a bevel gear pair for following specification using Barth factor and wear consideration, okay. So power given 90 kilowatt, input speed given 360 rpm, reduction ratio, that means velocity ratio, given 3, shaft angle given 90 degree, that means power is transmitted at 90 degree by the bevel gear. Application washing machine, this gear is used in washing machine. Assumptions, we have before solving this question, we have to assume certain values. That is, first assumption is that 20 degree full depth involute. We assume that the angle is full depth or 20 degree involute system. Material selection for pinion and gear is alloy steel. So we assume the material for pinion and gear is same, that is alloy steel. And we also take the value for alloy steel, that is ultimate tensile strength is equal to 800 megapascal. And the third assumption is value of factor of safety is 1.5. service factor is 1.25 and loads distribution factor is 1.4. These value is taken from values. We can now first find out the pitch cone angle. Okay, pitch cone angle to pinion. Okay, so assume if the number of teeth for pinion and number of teeth for gear is not given, so we will assume TP is equal to 18. This is the minimum number of teeth to avoid the interference. So if these values is not given for TP and TG and there is no condition for finding TP and TG, we can assume teeth on pinion is equal to 18. Okay, and this is the minimum number of teeth to avoid interference. So by finding by assuming TP is equal to 18, we easily get the value of TG, that means 18 into 3, because 3 is the velocity ratio given. So 18 into 3 is equal to 54. So by finding TP and TG, we can easily find out pitch cone angle for pinion and gear. So pitch cone angle for pinion is equal, we can find out by putting the values in formulas, that is 18.43. And pitch cone angle for gear, we can easily find out by putting these values, 71.57. After finding the pitch cone angle, we can find out the virtual number of teeth or formative number of teeth by putting the formula. So, before finding the virtual number of teeth, we can find out bending stress, that is SUT divided by 3. This is the formula for finding the bending stress if the ultimate tensile strength is given. So ultimate tensile strength is given, that is 800 Newton per millimeter square, and divided by 3 gives you 266.67 megapascal, and megapascal is nothing, is equal to Newton per millimeter square. So by after that, we can easily find out equivalent number of teeth for pinion and equivalent number of teeth for gear by putting these values. After finding the equivalent number of teeth for gear and pinion, we can find out the Lewis form factor for 20 degree full depth. For 20 degree full depth, we can easily take the formulation from the data design book, and that formulation is 0.484 minus 2.87 divided by TEP for the pinion, and similarly for the gear. As we already discussed that if the gear and pinion are made of same material, then pinion is always weaker. So we will design for pinion only. We don't require to check for the weaker section if the both material, both the members of the gears are made of same material. So we will design for pinion only. So from here, we can easily find out the pitch circle diameter for pinion and pitch circle diameter for gear from the formulation of module. And what is the formula for module? Formula for module is equal to pitch circle diameter of pinion divided by pitch circle diameter divided by teeth on the pinion. Similarly, formula for the module for gear is pitch circle diameter for gear divided by teeth. So by finding the DP and DG, we will get the value of pitch cone angle, that is A naught, or pitch cone distance, that is A naught, is equal to 28.46. And we will easily get the face width from these two values, A naught by 3 or 10 mm. Which one is lesser, we will take that value. If A naught by 3 is lesser, then we take A naught by 3. If 10 mm is lesser, then we will take 10 mm. In this condition, there is 9.5 mm module, that is A naught by 3 is lesser. So after finding A naught, we will put all these values in the bending strength equation or Lewis equation. By putting these values, we will get the value in the form of module. Okay, and after finding the value of FB in module form, that is 561.5 module, then we compare this value with the help of effective load. Then you know that what is the formula of effective load, that is KM, KT, FT, KM, KA, KFT by CB. So FT is equal to power by velocity, power divided by velocity. So velocity is already calculated earlier from the same formula, that is pi dg ng divided by 60 is equal to 0.34 module. Okay, so students, in this case you know that the pinion has the weaker section, so we will take dp, not ng. Here we will take dp and np because both the material are of same material. So estimation of module, we will compare fb with this factor of safety multiplied by F effective. We will get the value of M, that is 9 mm, and by putting the module in different values, that is face width and DP and DG, we will get the different dimensions for the gear, bevel gear. And in the this question, we will also design for wear strength. So the formula for wear strength is dg into b into q into k. So in this question, we know that the weaker member is a pinion. So we will take dp, not dg. And by putting the whole values, that means the formula of Q, formula of K, finding these values and putting these values in this question and comparing this value with the FW, with F effective into factor of safety, we will get the BHN, that is Brinell hardness number. So this is the complete solution of this numerical. So you can easily solve these numericals on bevel gear, and you don't need to go further. If you solve 10 numericals from each section, that means spur gear, helical gear, you can easily solve the numerical in your theoretical exams. So till then, thank you. Meet you in the next session with the new topic. Learning, keep watching and keep enhancing your knowledge. Thank you.